his favorite 5 minutes of the week.
All I hear was put me in the boat here. I only get healthy on the time so I can, you know, enjoy.
Well, there's a reason for this. We can't trust him. I mean, yeah.
That's right.
I'm sitting at a round table with, you know, Mauricio and David or, you know, a bunch of fellas, and you're in there with Christy and the chalkboard.
Yeah, we
want to trade spots.
No, thank you.
Oh, okay. All right.
Enjoy.
Okay. What are you going to be talking about in the door?
I'll be talking about, again, if we match, still again, illustrating, you know, what we're trying to do, and it all evolved to the forwards, to give them space and give them time to move. And what we saw last week was a little bit about our midfield three dropping back a little bit too much, which meant the service to the forwards wasn't as good. And I'm going to talk a little bit about that when we get the ball through earlier, and the midfield need to have confidence in their back four to be able to hold that defence together. And we're going to have 2.5 minutes or so, and we can watch that. Just think about tomorrow's game and what you're looking for. You should be able to see those formations take part on the field. You should be see them line up. And you should see and be able to identify the three in midfield, the three at the front. And that gives you a greater perspective of the game. And if you're not a player or not, you know, you haven't had much to do with soccer over the years, it's not like the national game in the US. I mean, you all know 100 times more about football than I do, NFL football. Do you understand this? It gives you a better perspective of what's going on in the field.
That's
going
to be a lot for the Catholic on the kickoff again. 11 o'clock, CW72. And if you miss it tonight, tomorrow morning, 8:30 on Fox TV. And then that's the 17.2 for CW17. And then, who knows, you may be able to catch it before the game if you're in the right spot out there at the Outer Bank Field. And one other thing we want to get to before we take a break here. It is official this week. The Amato will play in the U.S. Open Cup in 2015. The coming year, third round, and then the NASL teams join the bracket. That takes off May 27th. The MLS coming in the fourth round. That's June 16th and 17th. And you can so the first, the third round match will probably be something on the USL Pro side or something of that ilk. But the fourth round could be against a team from the MLS, and I know there's a process by which you say whether you need to or don't want to host or matches. I would think that there's a chance that another MLS team may be coming to Jacksonville as part of the U.S. Open Cup this summer.
I'm looking forward to us having a run in the U.S. Open Cup. That would be so much. That would be so good for Mana. And let's see how we go through the season, because if we start to play well during the season and win a few games, the MLS are going to be looking at us. They've been looking at us and saying, hey, I'm not sure I want part of them in the US Cup.
Yeah.
And if we can make it and play well and then get to that stage, the first stage, which is what, May the 27th?
Yes.
I would love us to have a run in the US Cup.
Oh, that'd be great. Yeah, love to see.